I recently made a vlog using the A7C and Tamron 28-75. While I was filming, I realized that I had been shooting without IBIS turned on, which resulted in a ton of shaky footage. I decided to just adjust the editing style so it still worked out, but someone reminded me that you can use Catalyst Browse with the A7C. I decided to go back to my old clips and take a look. Based on what I had heard, I thought you'd only have good results with a high shutter speed, but I was curious to see if the footage I shot at a normal shutter speed could still be used. I downloaded Catalyst Browse and ran a few clips through it, and in short, I was pleasantly surprised. So those clips were a mix of my A7C in a handheld rig and stripped down to just the cage. Focal lengths were anywhere from 28-75mm, and of course, IBIS was disabled while shooting. The workflow for Catalyst Browse isn't too bad, but I can see it becoming tedious very quickly since you have to go clip by clip. This is because auto settings often crop too much for my liking, which means I have to dial in the crop manually, and I'm assuming that others will feel the same. If you're wondering what that workflow looks like, first you open up Catalyst Browse and navigate to the folder containing your clips. Double-click a clip you want to watch, and now you'll be able to see the other clips in the folder on the left, a playback view in the middle, and all the metadata on the right. It also shows you whether or not image stabilizer was on at the time of shooting. From here, look to the left column, right-click the clip you want to stabilize, and click Stabilize Clip. Catalyst Browse will analyze your clip and automatically make adjustments. In the example here, Catalyst overshoots the crop in my opinion. I'm wondering if this is due to the proper shutter speed, but this seems to consistently be the case. This is why I switched the stabilization mode to manual and slide the cropping ratio slider to the right until I'm satisfied with both the crop and level of stability. I can see why people are recommending higher shutter speeds, since any motion blur looks very unnatural after stabilization. I can still see this being a creative tool, however, if you're making flashy cuts for social media or anything where the extra visual flair would be beneficial. From here, we press the upload or export symbol beside the I symbol. Choose the destination where you want to save it to. I like to add a suffix to the end of the file names and export to a separate folder just to keep things organized and to differentiate from the source clips. I believe I haven't touched the settings at all, but feel free to take a look at the settings I'm using. After all of this, scroll down and press export. Yo, editing. I said that I didn't touch the settings, but there's something called the render preset. By default, Catalyst chooses the best match for your clip, and I'm not sure what the parameters are or how it chooses, but I've noticed that it was choosing the slower or lower bitrate. Changing this to 100 megabits per second will provide much better quality, and I would highly recommend you do so as well. Other things I noticed while testing Catalyst, sometimes there will be errors in exporting, and usually just exporting one more time fixes it. I don't know why these errors take place, to be quite honest with you. Another thing I noticed is that you won't be able to stabilize anything shot in 120 frames per second. I believe it'll work with 60 frames, but I'm not exactly sure. Let's see. Even with APS-C mode enabled, you are able to stabilize the clips in Catalyst Browse. Oh, huge thing. IBIS, even if it's enabled, you are able to stabilize it further with gyro stabilization. Sometimes it leads to very weird movements and artifacts, especially if it's stable in the original clip, and then you run it through gyro stabilization, it just becomes a little bit weirder. So I can see why everybody's saying you have to disable IBIS for this to work. I also have a suspicion that, at least for the A7C, rolling shutter is a terrible, terrible thing in 4K that's hindering the performance of the gyro stabilization in Catalyst Browse. And again, I might do a few more tests, but I'll probably throw that into a separate video. Catalyst Browse and warp stabilization plus IBIS enabled. A few other factors thrown in, but I don't know, I can't commit to it yet. I think that's it for all the extra notes I wanted to slip in. We'll go back to the video now. An interesting thing to note is that I didn't have the option of stabilizing my clips with anything shot on my Pergear 12mm f2. I believe it's because there's no metadata being transferred with manual lenses, so I'm going to assume that this won't work with any adapt glass using dummy adapters as well. All in all, I'm very impressed by the software though, and so glad that the A7C got this gyro stabilization feature. I don't think I'll be using it that often though, since it's tedious and I don't want to have to shoot at an unnatural shutter speed, but I might use it for creative applications depending on what I'm shooting. I'm also very optimistic of the potential for it to be better integrated with editing software and improvements in general. Anyways, thanks for your time. Hope you enjoyed the video. Feel free to subscribe and like. And as always, be healthy. Bye.